Hi guys, it is a gorgeous but unbelievably Wednesday, Friday, May 3rd, 2013. I've been waiting for 2 hours for this wind to die down so I can get up on my rock and bring you my regular Friday feature called my Ecological Meltdown Roundup. But I've given up, and so I will just bring it to you directly from here in my trailer, since I can't walk outside into this Arctic blast to my rock. But whether from my rock or from this trailer, it's all the same, because this is probably the easiest job I have every week, where I simply turn on my Friday morning email to get these two emails that more than any others turn me into a hopeless, depressed collapsitarian. And I'm talking about the emails, this email called Endangered Earth from my friends at the Center for Biological Diversity, and then the second and best email of all from mangabay.com, which I will get to in a minute. But let's start right here, and I'm just gonna stab through some of these guys. This is some of the headlines coming out of Center for Biological Diversity, and I will put the links to both of these excellent newsletters, as I do every week, so you can get these same emails in your email every Friday, so you too can become a doomsday prophet, an environmental alarmist, and a depressed collapsitarian. Okay, let's get right into it. Cruel trap kills sister of wandering wolf OR7. All right. We just learned that the sister of Oregon's renowned canine adventurer Oregon OR7, the first wild gray wolf to set foot in California in nearly 90 years, has been killed. OR5, a three-year-old member of Oregon's Imnaha pack, died in a painful foothold trap in Idaho on March 30th. The pack is quickly diminishing. In addition to the loss of OR5, the pack's OR9 wolf was shot last year by an Idaho man under an expired hunting license, and OR16 was shot earlier in this year while trotting along an Idaho ridge top. The latest wolf deaths come just as the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service readies a plan to remove Endangered Species Act protections for wolves across much of the rest of the lower 48. All right, that's what's going on over there with the wolves. Okay, next story. U.S. study: EPA fails to protect wildlife from pesticides, which of course is one of its job descriptions, is to protect wildlife from pesticides. All right. A report released Tuesday by the National Academy of Sciences outlined problems with the EPA's oversight of dangerous pesticides. The study found that the EPA has not relied on the best scientific information. It has not effectively coordinated with wildlife agencies, and it has not adequately analyzed the effects of pesticides on wildlife. What a surprise. Okay. Let's see, I'm going to skip over the wolverines and go down here to the sea turtles, where we find every year Mexican fisheries off of the southern Baja California coast accidentally catch and kill more than 2,000 endangered loggerhead turtles. Just last summer, sea turtle strandings reached a record high when 483 loggerhead turtles were found dead along one 25-mile stretch of coastline, which is 600% more than average. Baja California has the highest concentration of sea turtle deaths in the world because so many Mexican fisheries overlap key sea turtle feeding grounds. Okay, that's from wolves to sea turtles. Now let's go back to the never-ending tragic story of bats, where we find that white nose fungus could wipe out Indiana bats. Okay. A scientific study released last week brought ominous news that the endangered Indiana bats will virtually disappear within about 10 years from large portions of their range because of white nose syndrome, the bat epidemic that has already killed nearly 7 million animals since it first appeared in 2006 and is rapidly spreading across the West and South. And then I've had plenty of rants already. They go into a story about California fracking, about how oil fracking ramping up in California. As you know, big oil and big gas fall all over themselves to destroy this planet. Okay, and let me go through all of my my alternate headlines and my international living headlines and oil price headlines and Amazon watch headlines. Good God, and here's my favorite one, my mangabay.com weekly newsletter for this week, where Manga Bay, my number one environmentalist organization, surveys both the mainstream and alternative media from around the planet this past week to bring you stories of the ongoing collapse of this planet. And I'm not surprised at all to see they start their worldwide survey here in Peru. This is talking about what happens to ecosystems and wildlife in areas where there is a total lack of government presence and no money coming in for its protection. Okay, so I guess you have to go on the link to find the story of one rural Peruvian community that took conservation matters into their own hands. But there's links to all of these stories, but I'm just touching on the headlines. All right, then from there, we go climate to climate myths. How climate denialists are getting away with bad science. But anyway, these are just some feature stories. Okay, let's get into the actual news stories for the week. Here we have Drill Baby Drill, the fate of African biodiversity and the monkey you have never heard of. All right, from there, from Africa, let's go over there to Brazil, where we find sugar cane production impacting local climate in Brazil. All right, intensification of Brazil's sugarcane industry in response to rising demand for sugar-based ethanol could have impacts on the regional climate, reports a new study by Arizona State University, Stanford University, and these others. Following the conversion of Cerrado grasslands into sugarcane in Brazil, and about how it's, you know, ramping up climate change as we fight the climate change from oil, from fossil fuels, by moving into these horse shit biofuel production in sugar cane, how we see that is no answer at all. Okay, from Brazil, let's go over to Taiwan. 13-year search for Taiwan's top predator comes up empty-handed. After 13 years of searching for the Formosan clouded leopard, once optimistic scientists say they believe the cat is now likely extinct. One more hopeful scientist joining the list of collapsed depressitarians. Okay, blah, blah, blah. I'm just, for the interest of time, I'm just throwing darts at this. I could do a lot more than this, but if you go on this link, you will find all of these stories and many more. But anyway, okay, let's go from Taiwan to Arkansas, where a citizen group finds 30 toxic chemicals in the air following a tar sands oil spill in Arkansas. All right. Independent air samples by locals have yielded a, quote, soup of toxic chemicals, close quote, in Mayflower, Arkansas, where an ExxonMobil pipeline burst on March 29th, spilling some 5,000 barrels of Canadian tar sand oils. Chemicals detected including several linked to cancer, reproductive problems, and neurological impacts. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, from the suburbs of Arkansas, dealing with the effects of Canadian tar sands, let's go down there to the Amazon rainforest, where the indigenous tribes say effects of climate change already being felt in Amazon rainforest. All right. Tribal groups in the Earth's largest rainforest are already being affected by shifts wrought by climate change, reports a paper published last week in the British Journal. Anyway, one of these climate journals. The paper says that native populations are reporting shifts in precipitation patterns, humidity, river levels, temperature, and fire in agricultural scientists. All right. We go from the Amazon over there to Malaysia. All right, where we find this interesting headline, Malaysia may loan Indonesia rhinos to save species from extinction. Conservationists and officials meeting last month at a rhino crisis summit in Singapore agreed to a radical plan to loan Sumatran rhinos between nations to save the critically endangered species from extinction. Of course, the proposal could still be thwarted by red tape and political opposition. Okay, then we just go next door to Borneo, where we find cement producers hunting for limestone could threaten Borneo caves. Jesus, it just never ends. As the planet eaters just plunder every corner of this planet to make their goddamn cement or whatever. Oh boy, then we go to this hopeful headline. Mining companies must turn to recycling as demand for metals grows. All right, demand for metals is likely to increase tenfold. As developing economies surge ahead, putting severe stress on the natural environment, according to a new report from the United Nations Environmental Program has warned. Okay, so how recycling is going to save us all. All right, here's this yo-yo story on Asia Pulp and Paper, that giant planet eater, has announced, a forest conservation policy, its newest. How some planet-eating corporation by the name of Asia Pulp and Paper is claiming how they are such responsible environmental stewards. The announcement, however, was met by skepticism in the environmental movement due to APP's failures to abide by all of its previous commitments to avoid rainforest logging. Huh. Let's see, I just mentioned this story in earlier over there from Center for Biological Diversity, but here is Manga Bay's announcement. Obama administration proposes stripping protection from all gray wolves. The U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service is proposing to end protection for all gray wolves in the lower 48 states, save for a small population of Mexican wolves in New Mexico. And I've reported on that. That great wolf pack. I think there's about 10 wolves in that pack. Okay, since the protection was stripped in Montana and Idaho, over 1,500 wolves have already been killed. Okay, then we go from gray wolves to bee collapse, honeybee collapse disorder caused by pesticides. From there, let's see, from honeybee collapse, let's go back down to the Belo Monte Dam in Brazil, where I need to watch. It's a link to a new documentary highlighting the battle over monster dam projects imperiling local people and wild rivers. The documentary argues that hydroelectric products cannot be deemed green energy. Yeah, right. Because they overturn lives, livelihoods, and ecosystems. But anyway, I urge you to click on this link to this featured documentary. I will definitely be watching that one. Let's see. Let's go from the Amazon jungle, skipping ahead, back over to Singapore, where probe confirms that Singapore-based palm oil company engaged in land grabbing in Borneo. I need to have more rants about this whole concept of land grabbing. All right, an independent investigation has shown that some planet-eating palm oil company failed to obtain proper consent from local communities before clearing rainforests for plantations in Indonesian Borneo, an Indonesian indigenous rights group reported last week. And of course, this planet-eating corporation, First Resources Limited, is a member on this absolutely horseshit joke, the group, which I mentioned before in this rant, called the Round Table on Sustainable Palm Oil. Guys, anybody who believes that palm oil is sustainable on any level, pull your head out of your ass. Okay, here's a headline. Great tits unaffected by warmer springs. Okay, so if you have great tits, that is something, that is one thing not being affected by warmer spring is great tits. Good news for Playboy magazine. All right, from that story, let's go back over to Mozambique, where we get the news that rhinos are now extinct in Mozambique's Limpopo National Park. This is an easy to understand headline. Poachers have killed off the last rhino in Mozambique's protected Limpopo National Park, according to park officials. Okay, from Mozambique in sub-Saharan Africa, let's go up there to Nigeria, where top security official blames climate change for worsening insecurity. Climate change is in part to blame for rising conflict and crime in Nigeria. As Africa collapses from Mozambique to Nigeria, as everything from rhino poaching to climate change. Oh boy. And then let's go back over there to Southeast Asia, where we find Samsung Corporation admits to using 10 linked to child labor and deforestation. And there you go. Oh boy. We just had one about rhino poaching in Mozambique. And here we go over to the Central African Republic. Once again, emergency. Large number of elephants being poached in the Central African Republic. The World Wildlife Fund and the Wildlife Conservation Society are issuing an immediate call for action as they report that poachers are killing sizable numbers of forest elephants. I think I had that rant last week. Okay, and then back to palm oil. Environmentalists unhappy with the new palm oil standard. Environmentalists are unhappy with Thursday's approval of new criteria for the world's leading palm oil certification standard. Oh boy, you know, once again, and one more story about this horseshit joke of an organization, the Round Table on Sustainable Palm Oil. Oh boy. Anyway, guys, this just goes on and on. But I see I'm running out of time here. So if you just want to read more and more of this, and there were plenty of stories that I just did not mention, but anyone who is unclear of the ongoing and not the imminent in the future collapse of this planet, the ongoing environmental collapse of this planet, can simply get these newsletters for themselves. But I will wrap up this week's Ecological Meltdown Roundup for the week and bundle up so I can head out of this trailer here at 12:13 p.m. for the first time to survive a May 3rd spring day in Austin, Texas. But this is your doomsday prophet, environmental alarmist, and depressed collapsitarian wrapping up this rant and saying, bye guys.